The vertex form of a quadratic function is f of x equals a times the square of x minus h plus k, where the vertex is the ordered pair h comma k. But why is h comma k the vertex when the quadratic function is in this form? If you've ever wondered, this is a lesson for you. Recall if a is negative, the parabola opens down as pictured below, and the vertex is the highest point on the graph. And if a is positive, the parabola opens up, and the vertex is the lowest point on the graph. Recall in our previous lesson, we talked about the general form of a quadratic function, where the form f of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c, and we explained why the vertex is the ordered pair negative b divided by 2a comma f of negative b divided by 2a. We're going to use this to show in vertex form h comma k is the vertex. So let's quickly review how we determine the vertex must be negative b divided by 2a comma f of negative b divided by 2a when the quadratic function is in general form. Recall to find the zeros of any function or the specific quadratic function, we set f of x equal to 0 and solve. If the solutions are real, then the zeros would also represent x-intercepts on the graph of the parabola. Setting f of x equal to 0, we have the equation ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, which we can solve using the quadratic formula. Using the quadratic formula in the form here on the right, if we assume the zeros are real, then the graph of the parabola would have the x-intercepts as expressed below, and the graph might look something like this, where the x-intercept on the left would be the ordered pair negative b divided by 2a minus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a comma 0, and the x-intercept on the right would be the ordered pair negative b divided by 2a plus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a comma 0. From here, notice the x-coordinate of the midpoint of this green segment, where the endpoints are the x-intercepts, would give us the x-intercept of the vertex, as well as the equation for the axis of symmetry. In the previous lesson, we found the x-coordinate of the midpoint by summing the two x-coordinates of the x-intercepts, or the endpoints of the green segment, which we saw was equal to negative b divided by 2a, indicating this must be the x-intercept of the vertex. And of course, the y-coordinate would have to be f of negative b divided by 2a. And now let's go back to the vertex form of a quadratic function and show h comma k must be the vertex. To do this, we'll start with the general form of a quadratic function and write it in vertex form. To do this, the first step is to factor a from the x squared and x terms. Notice the x term doesn't have a factor of a, and therefore, if we factor out a from the first two terms, we have f of x equals a times the sum of x squared and b divided by a times x. Notice if we distribute, a times b divided by a times x does equal bx. Notice a divided by a simplifies to 1. Now we need to complete the square on the expression inside the parentheses. Recall to complete the square, we need to add the square of half of the coefficient of x inside the parentheses, which would be the square of the product of 1 half and b divided by a, which is b squared divided by 4a squared. So we add this inside the parentheses, which we see here. Now notice if we distribute the a, one factor of a simplifies out, and we have plus b squared divided by 4a, which we also have to subtract to maintain equality, which we see here on the very end. And now the quadratic inside the parentheses is a perfect square trinomial, meaning it will factor into two equal binomial factors. The constant in the binomial factors will be the expression we squared to get b squared divided by 4a squared, which we can see here in red is b divided by 2a, which gives us f of x equals a times two factors of x plus b divided by 2a. And then to combine c minus b squared divided by 4a, we obtain the least common denominator of 4a, multiplying c by 4a divided by 4a. C minus b squared divided by 4a is equal to the quantity 4ac minus b squared divided by 4a. And now to write the quadratic function in vertex form, we have f of x equals a times the square of x plus b divided by 2a plus the quantity 4ac minus b squared divided by 4a. Now that we have the quadratic function in vertex form, let's identify h as well as k. Comparing what we just found to f of x or y equals a times the square of x minus h plus k, because in vertex form we have the square of x minus h, notice h would have to be negative b divided by 2a, which we know from our previous work is the x-coordinate of the vertex. Now we just need to show that k, which is equal to the quantity 4ac minus b squared divided by 4a, is equal to f of negative b divided by 2a. Using the vertex form that we just found, if we substitute negative b divided by 2a for x, we have a times the square of negative b divided by 2a plus b divided by 2a plus the quantity 4ac minus b squared divided by 4a. Notice we have 0 inside the parentheses, showing that k, or f of h, is equal to the quantity 4ac minus b squared divided by 4a, verifying this would be the x-coordinate of the vertex. Let's also show that f of negative b divided by 2a using general form results in the same expression. Let's do this on the next slide. Subbing in negative b divided by 2a for x in general form, we have the y-coordinate of the vertex, k, equals a times the square of negative b divided by 2a plus b times negative b divided by 2a plus c. And now simplifying, the square of negative b divided by 2a equals b squared divided by 4a squared, and b times negative b divided by 2a results in minus b squared divided by 2a. And of course, we still have plus c. And a times b squared divided by 4a squared equals b squared divided by 4a, because one factor of a simplifies out. Obtaining the least common denominator of 4a, we multiply b squared divided by 2a by 2 divided by 2, and c by 4a divided by 4a, giving us b squared divided by 4a minus 2b squared divided by 4a plus 4ac divided by 4a, which simplifies to the quantity 4ac minus b squared divided by 4a, which verifies this expression will be the y-coordinate of the vertex, and therefore h, k is the vertex of any quadratic function when the equation is in vertex form. I hope you found this helpful.